This video is produced by the South Australian Stroke Clinical Network as a training tool for nurses and doctors. It explains the code stroke scenario, which we use in this state to ensure rapid assessment of patients to enable administration of thrombolysis wherever possible. Okay, so the bolus is at 11:40, and we'll keep a close eye on you. The community need to recognise a stroke and know what to do. Spread the word of FAST. F for face asymmetry of smile, A for arm weakness, S for speech disturbance, and T for telephone 000 in Australia, and note the time. Once the ambulance service have been called, the code stroke process begins. And the time of onset was? Okay, see you in ED. Thanks for the call.
Roger, we'll see you on arrival.
Following the pre-notification, the stroke nurse then activates the hospital code stroke team. The stroke team meets the patient on arrival in the emergency department. ISBAR is a tool used to provide effective and accurate communication. I for introduction, in this case the 49-year-old Mr. Bob Major. S for situation, he was at work with a sudden onset of left face arm leg weakness and slurred speech. Time of onset was 11 o'clock. The B for background, he lives independently at home with a past medical history of atrial fibrillation. A is for assessment, the Rosier score, recognition of stroke in the emergency room. He scored 4 with a face, arm, leg, weakness and slurred speech. R is for recommendations, an acute assessment by the stroke team for suitability for thrombolysis. In a code stroke scenario, all members of the emergency department and stroke team have predefined roles, so it's a very rapid assessment of the patient. We do things like heart tracing, taking bloods, putting in a gel co, telling the patient what's going to happen, doing a neurological assessment, and then transferring them to radiology within about 15 minutes. The National Institute for Health Stroke Severity Scale is known as the NIS. It enables doctors and nurses all over the world to make a standardised assessment of the severity of stroke. Bob, we need to do a neurological examination on you. Tell me how old you are.
49.
What month is it now?
It's March.
Do this for me. Close your eyes. Now open them. With your hand, make a fist and open it out. See my pen here? Don't take your eyes off my pen. Follow my pen all the way. Point to the finger that wiggles. Point to the finger that wiggles. Okay, so it's got some left visual neglect. Give me a great big smile. Show me all your teeth. Screw up your eyes tight and raise up your eyebrows. So it's weak on that left side. Now, I need to know whether you can feel this is sharp.
Yes.
Can you feel this?
Yes.
But it's not as sharp. What about here?
Yeah.
And here?
Just.
Okay, sharper on the right or the left?
Much sharper.
What about here?
Again, I can
so you can feel it, but it's not as sharp. Yeah. So we've got some left sensory loss. Lift up your right arm. Keep it up. Keep it up strong for 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Lovely. Lift this little one up for me. Come on, lift it up. What can you do? Anything at all? It's pretty weak, isn't it? Okay. So I'm going to give him a 3 for his arm. Lift up your right leg. Keep it up for 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Rest down. Lift up your left one. Come on, lift it up. What have we got here? Anything? Okay, it's still very weak. With this finger, touch my finger, touch your nose. Back to my finger, back to your nose, back to my finger, back to your nose. Can you try with your left hand?
All right.
Okay, there's no ataxia there. Now, just rattle these words off for me, please.
Pip, stone, 15, catastrophe, impossibility.
Yeah.
So we'll need to rush down to the CT scanner. I've rung them to say we're on our way. Hi Andrew, this is Bob Major for his code stroke imaging.
Hi Bob, have you ever had a CT before?
I don't think so.
I'm going to take you in and see what we can do for you, sir.
As part of the code stroke imaging protocol, all or some of the imaging is performed. Everyone gets a plain CT scan to determine the type of stroke and to rule out a bleed. CT angiogram is performed to look at the intra and extracranial vessels. A perfusion scan may also be performed, which highlights already infarcted brain or whether there's brain at threat of infarction. This is the penumbra, and that's the brain you're trying to save. In preparation for thrombolysis, the patient must be informed of the risks. 1, the drug will do nothing. 2, it may make you better or totally better. 3, and this is important, it could make you worse. It could make you bleed from anywhere in your body, especially your brain, which could be serious and even life-threatening. Other problems include allergic reaction and local bruising. Reassure the patient they will be monitored very carefully for signs of deterioration over the next 24 hours. There are absolute contraindications to thrombolysis, which include if there's no clear time of onset, an uncontrolled blood pressure of 185 over 110, serious bleeding or clotting disorders, an INR of greater than 1.5, or seizure at onset without vessel occlusion. Relative contraindications include recent heart attacks, strokes, head injuries, a very severe stroke with a NIS of greater than 22, operations or biopsies. The stroke doctor will discuss the patient with the consultant. He will give him a clear time of onset, the clinical findings, the medical history, the blood test results, and the results of the CT scan. The consultant will review the images and the patient and decide whether thrombolysis is indicated. And the drug will only be offered if the stroke consultant thinks it's the best treatment for the patient.
Bob, I want you to sign this consent form for thrombolysis. Okay.
Bob, how much do you weigh?
89 kilos.
89 kilos. The total dose is 80.1. 10% bolus is 8. 60ml infusion is 72.1. And we're using 2 50mg vials.
Okay, so our infusion will be 72.1.
Let's go.
Actilize is given 0.9 milligrams per kilogram. The maximum dose is 90 milligrams. It will come in a 50 milligram vial and a 10 milligram vial. The patient will have cardiac monitor in situ and be constantly checked to observe for bleeding, headache, changes in clinical signs, signs of allergic reaction, angioedema, and anaphylaxis is rare but possible.
All right, Bob, we're going to keep a close eye on you.
By completing standardised neurological and frequent vital signs observations, early detection of deterioration will be made. The modified NIS includes questions on level of consciousness, visual fields, gaze, arm and leg movement, sensation, language and whether there's neglect, with a possible score out of 32. If the score increases by 4 or more, the patient is deteriorating and will need urgent medical review and possible rescan of the brain to rule out a bleed. You'll be pleased to know that our patient, Bob Major, made a good recovery with his thrombolysis and was discharged to rehabilitation on day 3.